Good morning, Nikotons. I wish to let you know that we are approaching our goal of 1 million.
Of such vain things. False kings of the earth had set themselves on the ruler's state council together. Against the Lord God, the Rastafari, and against his anointed, saying, "Now come, let us break their bands of sunder and cast away the cards from us. Your leader seated as ever shall laugh. The Lord God, the Rastafari, shall have them in his region. But then shall he speak unto them in his wrath and vex to them in his soul his pleasure. God, yet have I set thy kings upon the holy mountains of Zion. I will know the clear decree. The Lord God, the Rastafari, had said unto I and I, that thou art thy sons this day by begotten thee. Now ask the fire, and then I shall give thee the Eden for thy inheritance, and the uttermost part of the earth for thy possession. Yes, shall break them with the rod of fire. Yes, and that's them in peace and like a pot of vessels, I will say. So be wise, therefore, kings, and be struck to thee, for I'll judge it of the search. Serve the Lord God, your Rastafari, with fear, rejoice, with tremble. Kiss I neither son, unless he be anger, but perish from his ways when his wrath is kindled but a little. And so blessed be all, blessed be everyone, as I would say. Blessed be everyone, as I would tell you.
Mr. President, distinguished delegates.
የዓለም ጸጥታ አዋኪና ለሰላም ጉዳይ መሰናክል የሆኑትን ሁሉ አይነተኛ ችግሮች እዚህ ላይ ልንጠቅሳቸው እንፈቅዳለን።
Since the beginning of modern civilization, generations of weakness and inherited only conflicts of world wars. But behold the marriage supper of the lamb and bridegroom unto his bride. Then shall the earth's children know the true expression of one love. Then Mother Earth shall honeymoon in peace. Forever eliminating aspirations, lust, and anguish of wars and rumors of wars. See now.
See the now the innocent moving up in papers, and propaganda spreading in the Sunday papers. Not even Superman could have saved it in the papers. Render judgment a place. And Babylon a gamble the youth and life like racehorse. And give them a uniform and a shame them every praise us. And now the black has strike war on the amaze us. The men of them churches try to save us.
Can we do it? We can do it. We shall do it.
Boom! Tell them finna drown me out. When the world government in a falling out, only few man survive crawling out. Run left him, colleague them sprawling out. Nearly dead, they dig up y'all him out. And him too drunk with lies of his stall him out. The fan base can't get no calling out. When him hear from the shout last week, him mistress find a new shoes. Wife can't get no news and lately she starting to doubt. She still searching and the youth them balling out. Working hard to not let it all come out. Well it's not safe to go walk about. A slaughter house, some bug that's the water house. She start to rouse, sometimes she want a spouse. She start to out, start beat a dog. Guns come out, working people, guns run out. Keep a show last week and no one come out. Bombs come out, make a stunt, guns run out. Should the scotch tape bust on out? We'd run out, just since this must come out. Come up on round a bug, they a boss run out. Now come out, till the chalice burn out. Now come out, till the malice burn out. A war,
Zimbabwe to burning ball. Blazing like a burning ball. Loose ball at no working war. Sleeping at no working war. Can't wear Jerry Berlin bar. No diamond on Berlin bar. Can't drink with a serving bar. Just sip up of your nerves in war. Shut the blood off your shirt in war. Can't go lift up no skirt in war.
for the sign and the sign is us. Searching for the truth, all your find is us. Searching for the truth, still behind is us. The almighty recruit and we come from the root. We feel like roach killing boot. We just stand on Rastafari, design me tough. If I divide with freedom, sign me up. Can you tell I vision can't blind me up? Soldiers and police, them wise enough. Realizing they no more right than us. Realizing there's no use fighting us. Realizing they open their eyes to see the same team moralizing life as us. So we not take dark, now smiling up. Now the world temperate and jump boiling up. Follow, calling the shots and a bus. None controlling the mind of the young. Bring down,
fear from in the rain of fall. From London to Nailand Mall. All the son of the virgin fall. Institute of the church in war. Preaching and researching war. Practice and rehearsing war. Teaching and them learning war. Instigating and urging war. Always keep alerting war. When we jump out as working car. Now the bees and the birds in war. And the freaks and the nerds in war. And the straight and the curves in war. Forward and reverse in war.
Ready, ready.
You see, my brother made this bunny from scratch. It came from the backyard. That's my brother, Angel.
Morning, people.
Good morning to my brother.
Jerry Rastafari.
You know, see, his area is Florida, and he got the cassava from the backyard in the garden, and he makes his own cassava from scratch.
Amen.
He's high-ranking nutritional
cook
from the military, U.S. military. That's my brother.
Hello,
get many awards for it too. So don't you play with him. Don't take him for a joke. All right. He's brilliant.
Use it, you know, do the workout, one, two, bring it to your chest, three, four, you do the pull, you do the tight lift, or the lift, you know, if you're working out, it's basically, you know, strength training, aerobic, or circuit training, you know, yeah, work out the triceps, and the bicep, and the chest muscle, and the abdominals, the legs, because you're contracting them when you bend the knee, at the knee. So with your feet just about shoulder width apart, you pull, you know, you lift the tires. And you're using your abdominals, reduce the strain on your back by tilting it just about maybe 90 degree or 45 or 145, okay, correction on that. Or you can bend really at your knee and make your legs parallel to the ground. And then you can pull up, all right? And you work your groin area, the KG muscles, right? And then you do it. So these are just all alternative, and you can put it on a slider and push it, right? So, and then obviously you can use it as a and do the 1, 2, 3, 4 the triceps, right? This is an afternoon workout. You go one to the side. And you do the triceps, right? So this is a mix and match video. So when you get a, you can use a hammer. You can use a hammer or a solid object. that won't smash or peer into the almond. Alright. I know I'm on the ground here. I'm on the surface. So bear with me. You know, I'm mixing everything into one, but do wash your hands before you do this stuff here. Before you eat it. But I'm doing this just for the sake of time. We're gonna get into it. Alright. So, basically there's a... When you get it, you can hear it. That's that crack there. And you just peer it apart. And that's what it looks like. This here, as you can see, it looks like, whoa, this one fell on the ground. Excuse the madness, but it looks like this. And you can eat it. Real tasty. I'll do another one. So here it is. It's like a oval shape. It's oval in nature. Oval,
ladies,
as you can
see. Gentlemen, boys and girls, and friends of the universe.
And then when you want to smash it open, you hit the pointed.
We're gonna get in depth into the Word of God, just briefly. We won't get into too much detail, but however, I would love for you to continue the reading of some of these chapters and verses that are mentioned. You can extend it beyond the verse that I read and include all the chapters, you know, including all of the chapters. If I read only one verse, you might want to go ahead and read the whole chapter, because, you know, to edify the mind and enhance the understanding of the Word of God. So on this blessed day, I'll say a brief word of prayer, and we'll start at Exodus 23:25, and we'll get the message going. So I'll find it and I'll pause at Exodus 23:25 in the King James Version. If you have other edition, you are welcome to do so, to read from that version. You don't particularly have to read from the King James Version, but do read. And like I said, we'll start once I margin. I bookmark this Exodus 20:23. So, okay, here it is. Alright, so let's have a word of prayer. Oh, kind and ever Father Jesus, bless us. Strengthen our minds and our body. Father, as we continue the journey, this quest, to fill our mind with holy and spiritual thoughts of the Creator, of our body, for our mind, for our thought, because Jesus Christ, He died on the cross to save us, so we can live a more richer and fuller life in Jesus Christ. Amen. So Exodus 23:25, and it reads as such: And ye shall serve the Lord your God, and ye shall bless the bread and thy water, and I will take sickness away from the midst of thee. Such a lovely verse for our message today. Right? That includes enrichment of our mind, building up our body for strength, and having proper nutrition. Yeah. Protein doesn't have to always be animal. Right? Doesn't always have to be fruits. Doesn't always have to be grain. Can also be nuts, such as almond. A basic common almond that a lot of us, when we was growing up, we used, you know, we sat on the rock and got a hammer and beat on an almond and crack it open and enjoy on a summer afternoon. So such is this is the verse, and ye shall serve the Lord your God, and be, and he shall bless thy bread. Right, serving each other, you know, will multiply our blessing towards God. So friends and family, stay true to that calling, to that message.
When them want to feel well a G, some a fire shot dead in the street. Sorry for them, but me happy and no me. Some a youth chat on the blackboard. Some a sell front round a back road. Every hustle at the well a we a G. From when up easy you a pre, a the king. You no come but you broke. A yourself you a fuck your little tongue. Beef in a grand you give your mother feed the month. And a walk in a kitchen every minute and a munch. Is a pirate's dish you get for your lunch. Full a kick, full a box, wash it down with a punch. People a walk like dog. And you sit down and a big ball of ears ask how your ears are. Where them mother do fi be a millionaire? Where them mother do fi wall a G? Some a fire shot dead in a the street. Sorry for them but me happy and no me. Some a youth chat on the blackboard. Some a sell front round a back road. Every hustle at the well a we a G. Someone up easy you a pre a the key. Every teacher fi have a Benz with press button. So the youth them see send a leech a the key. But the system fuck up and I tell you say a me. So no flex when the kids a say a the chief. Politicians get the money and rabbit him. Now nah, make we get it him a take it bring it to him. We brainwash we circle fi a pretty phone. The fool we a be a gun we a follow. Where them mother do fi be a millionaire? Where them mother do fi wall a G? Some a fire shot dead in a the street. Sorry fi them but me happy and no me. Some a youth chat on the blackboard. Some a sell front down a back road. Every hustle at the wall a we a G. From a no prison you a pre a the king. The wall a we a G. Sorry fi them but me happy and no me. When I be a G, where them mother do fi be a millionaire? Where them mother do fi wall a G? Some a fire shot dead in a the street. Sorry fi them but me happy and no me. Some a youth chat on the blackboard. Some a sell front round a back road. Every hustle at the wall a be a G. Someone up easy you a pre a the king.
Hi, and welcome to our series, continuous series. We're going to be talking about, today we're going to talk about 10 things to increase your wealth, save money, and be happy. All right, the first thing, this is all we got today, just 10 things. I just got off the road, and I was real energized by it. I see some things there. Obviously, this is tying into our series, Outdoors, right? First thing first, okay? You know? Be excited, definitely. If you're excited, you're gonna make the sales anytime over anybody. If you're excited, show enthusiasm. Show excited to enthusiasm. You know, joy, passion. That's what you're gonna show to get the sales, to win the sales over. Because, you know, it's what you're passionate about. And passion tend to drive sales. So that's three. Now our four things is prepare. Make sure you know your stuff. You have the enthusiasm, the drive, the passion, but preparedness, having all the things, what you're gonna say to the client the moment you get inside the door, I mean, I'm talking before you even get inside the door. The moment you knock on the door, or how you open the door, are you stand, are you tall? I mean, all this thing ties into being prepared, you know, the material, the your verseness, understanding of it, how to, you know, break it down, how to, whether you can make a decision on spot, off spot, the ways to explain that, you know, okay, I might not be the person to give you a discount at this time, but I'll gladly get that person on the phone for you. So that's a technique you can use. Now that's our fourth. Our fifth point is be ready. Be ready to be asked questions and be able to rebuttal those questions. Now, I just mentioned just a short time ago is that you might not be the person to either, you know, reduce a sale or give a discount or stuff like that, or jobs at sort of price, or you know, give extra service and stuff like that. So that's where you got to be have the ability to do the rebuttal, right? To say, okay, I can't make that decision at this time, but I'll get my superior on the phone in the next 10 seconds. They're actually waiting for my call. I'm just here as a mouthpiece for the company. Now, that's one. The sixth way is how you dress. Are you prepared? Obviously, if you're going on the beach, you know, you're going to talk to a client on the beach. You want to dress bright, fresh, you know, you want to have like maybe a blue, a deep blue, or a turquoise, or a light bright green, not so much, but eagle, outdoor type, and beachy type. Now, obviously, don't go in there with a flip-flop on, right? So you want to go in there with a nice pants and a dress shirt. You can save the tie. Hat, I don't suggest that. Maybe a sunshade would be nice, but take it off when you go there. So our seventh there is to... Our seventh technique to be wealthy, happy, and rich is to know yourself. Know yourself inside out. That means, you know, have understanding and a working knowledge of yourself. You know, your weakness, your strength, right? This type of stuff you have to have to actually face the customer and talk to them. So those are the eighth technique is know your customer. Know your customer, life, strength, what type of business are they in? You know, you're gonna talk to a business owner different from a manager, because they can't make the same decision. One is the ultimate decision maker. One of them is the go-between, is sort of like a nudge in the side, say, okay, yeah, you can do it. That would be the manager, all right? Now, and our ninth technique is to constantly be aware of your surrounding, meaning, yeah, interruption, distraction, people, you might get a sudden call. You know, those are short techniques, not really necessary. Not that. The number 10 reason is to go out and make money. Just make money, right? Is you wrap up all those techniques, you know, be enthusiastic, have the drive, passion, know yourself, know your customer, be aware of your surrounding. Those are all the techniques you need to be successful. So go out there and make yourself some money and be happy. Sell a lot of texts, because hey, people love it. They check. Remember, the statistic don't lie, all right? And you follow the statistic, have that as your anchor, and you'll make money every single time. So go out there once again and be happy. Thanks for tuning in, and subscribe anytime, as always. And hey, let a friend know about us, all right? Because we are a force to be reckoned with. And a lot of stuff, the year just started, and you know, I mean, we are what, maybe four months into it, we still got eight to go. So that's plenty of time to crank up your gear, or you know, if you're not doing anything, to get started. So be happy, be merry, and 10 thumbs up. All right.
This is the inner ear me have avocado. Avocado rub, me have avocado rub in my head. So what me I go do now is see the avocado. Avocado I put in there, it's an avocado rub. The natural avocado I put in there. Yeah, something I look for right now. Eh? So I rub it in there. All the manufactured grease that's in the avocado gonna cling onto the ear strings, the ear lines, and it's supposed to leave a luster on it. So we'll see. I'm gonna wash it out in a minute and we'll see how it works out. All right, give me a second. So I'm heading towards where the pipe is, the stand pipe is, to wash out the avocado in it. This pipe is kind of short, so you have to bear with me. So see, this is a pipe, a stand pipe. It's short in comparison to where it needs to be. So I'm gonna wash it out. Not in the drum, mean I'm a yay. So I'm gonna wash out the ear. Put the thing in there for about every 5 minutes. So now I'm going to wash it out. This is probably about maybe half ounce of well ripe avocado. It's going to take some time to get washed out properly. As I said, it's about 4 ounces of about maybe half ounce. 4 ounces to half to 8 ounces of avocado. I rubbed in it and I let it sit here for about 5 minutes. Rub it in. You do a combination of rubbing. That technique, you can find this technique at nicogoods.com. That's nicogoods.com. It's gonna bring a natural luster inside the ear. So this is a custard and it has natural mineral property. See, you turn the pipe off and let that water settle. Once the water settle, you know, you're gonna wash it again until the water clear. So it's looking oh.
Yeah, my hair is receding, no problem. The water softened the hair. I'm not really seeing much shine, but you can tell that it have a marginal improvement than before. Cause on my hand it's smooth. And once I know my hand it's smooth, I know there's a difference in the ear. Might not be able to see it, but with a couple more application, yeah, this thing should look marvelous. I'm gonna wait for COVID activity over there. So. No, I'm not gonna blame them for one for being on the video. But yeah, you look at the scalp, it's washed clean, so it's good. I don't have to do another wash. I said wash and walk and wash here and look for property, look for housing development. So they must sell this property. It's 561-807-2760. Yeah, they must sell it. It's not a bad property. They commercialize it, but they must sell it. We'll not buy it. It's gonna be expensive because it's, you know, they turn it into a commercial building, but nevertheless, that's something for was your eye on. And you're not really worried too much about, you know, it's in a, it's in a residential area, so you can live and work in it. That's the beauty about it. You know? When the community, when the activity hype up, that's when they gonna come and maybe try to affect your business engagement, so. In those instant where you do is, you know, you start off here, I do manage rollout where, you know, you don't promote in a mass way where you have unsuspected or people who are just walking. You know, you do a schedule. Oh, man. Into a schedule format, and in doing so, you know, you won't get so much people who suspected, suspicious eyes watching you. I saw you to the Abbey. We're gonna end this one here on this long pause and continue. I'm gonna get a comb and get a nice comb. And yeah, you see, they have some shine part inside it, inside the ear. So, what I'm gonna have to do is avoid those harsh chemicals, because sometimes you have the chemical and don't let it stay in the ear for a long period of time. You know, you wash it, as soon as you wash it, you rinse it out. you know, no more than maybe 30 seconds. If you're just trying to take out dirt or, you know, some of the dirt out of the ear. That's why I use conditioner to wash my hair, you know. But when I use conditioner, I wash it well. I rinse it out. I lather up. I rub it in. And then when I'm, when it's, you know, I'm completely leathered in, I then wash it out well. You know, it rinse it out properly. So it doesn't affect the root of the ear. Because I might theorize on all your people gray. It's a natural combination of the product you affect your ear with and on your consumption, your diet consumption. You know? So those are my theory. Yeah. The different combination of that, I wouldn't really know. But I mean, you can always test it and see how it pan out. Yeah, so this is one of my video I haven't done in, and the avocado was tasty. So them say you are what you eat. And what you put in your ear too. So you see my nose is shiny, so on my forehead right here, where the so it has a little luster in it. You can tell the product have luster in it. Alright friends. Thanks for sharing some of your time with me today. And have a blessed day, you know. Your prayer. With proper supplication, life will flourish. Yeah, you know, so be good. And, you know, check out our website, read up. That's what we always trying to do. NicoGoods.com. And see the offerings there. And, you know, if you want to, you know, want to support the work, you can always, yeah, purchase one of our t-shirts, get a signed autograph copy of our shirt, and you know, and it's well labeled and printed in a modern facility. So rest assured, you're getting the best. All right. Hi, and welcome to our series, continuous series. We're going to be talking about, today we're going to talk about 10 things to increase your wealth, save money, and be happy. All right, the first thing, this is all we got today. It's just 10 things. I just got off the road, and I was real energized by it. I see some things there. This is tying into our series, Outdoors, right? First thing first, okay? You know? Be excited, definitely. If you're excited, you're gonna make the sales anytime over anybody. If you're excited, show enthusiasm. Show excited to enthusiasm. You know, joy, passion. That's what you're gonna show to get the sales, to win the sales over. Because, you know, it's what you're passionate about. And passion tends to drive sales. So that's three. Now, four things is prepare. Make sure you know your stuff. You have the enthusiasm, the drive, the passion, but preparedness, having all the things, what you're gonna say to the client, the moment you get inside the door. I mean, I'm talking before you even get inside the door, the moment you knock on the door, or how you open the door, are you stand, are you tall? I mean, all this thing ties into being prepared, you know, the material, your verseness, understanding of it, how to, you know, break it down, how to, whether you can make a decision on spot, off spot, the ways to explain that, you know, okay, I might not be the person to give you a discount at this time, but I'll gladly get that person on the phone for you. So that's a technique you can use. Now that's our fourth. Our fifth point is be ready. Be ready to be asked questions and be able to rebuttal those questions. Now, I just mentioned just a short time ago is that you might not be the person to either, you know, reduce a sale or give a discount or stuff like that, or jobs at sort of price, or you know, give extra service and stuff like that. So that's where you got to be at the ability to do the rebuttal, right? To say, okay, I can't make that decision at this time, but I'll get my my superior on the phone in the next 10 seconds. They're actually waiting for my call. I'm just here as a mouthpiece for the company. Now, that's one. The sixth way is how you dress. Are you prepared? Obviously, if you're going on the beach, you know, you're going to talk to a client on the beach. You want to dress bright, fresh. You know, you want to have, like, maybe a blue, a deep blue, or a turquoise, or a light green, light, bright green, not so much, but eagle, outdoor types, and beachy type. Now, obviously, don't go in there with a flip-flop on, right? So you want to go in there with a nice pants and a dress shirt. You can save the tie. Hat, I don't suggest that. Maybe a sunshade would be nice, but take it off when you go there. So our seventh there is to... Our seventh technique to be wealthy, happy, and rich is to know yourself. Know yourself inside out. That means, you know, I've understand and of working knowledge of yourself. You know, your weakness, your strength, right? This type of stuff you have to have to actually face the customer and talk to them. So those are the eighth technique is know your customer. Know your customer, life strength, what type of business are they in? You know, you're gonna talk to a business owner different from a manager, because they can't make the same decision. One is the ultimate decision maker. One of them is the go-between. It's sort of like a nudge in the side, say, okay, yeah, you can do it. That would be the manager, all right? Now, and our ninth technique is to constantly be aware of your surroundings. Meaning, interruption, distraction, people, you might get a sudden call. You know, those are short techniques, not really necessary. Not that. The number 10 reason is to go out and make money. Just make money, right? Is you wrap up all those techniques, you know, be enthusiastic, have the drive, passion, know yourself, know your customer, be aware of your surroundings. Those are all the techniques you need to be successful. So go out there and make yourself some money and be happy. Sell a lot of tests, because hey, people love it. They check. Remember, the statistic don't lie, all right? And you follow the statistic, have that as your anchor, and you'll make money every single time. So go out there once again and be happy. Thanks for tuning in, and subscribe anytime as always. And hey, let a friend know about us, all right? Because we are a force to be reckoned with, and a lot of stuff, the year just started. You know, I mean, we are what, maybe four months into it. We still got eight to go, so that's plenty of time to crank up your gear, or you know, if you're not doing anything, to get started. So be happy, be merry, and 10 thumbs up.